These extinct terrestrial giants are one of the most enigmatic we've ever discovered. They stood as tall as streetlights, only much wider across, and were peppered across the land on every corner of the planet. Nope, I'm not talking about dinosaurs or giant mammals. I'm talking about absurdly enormous ancient mushrooms. These are the Prototaxites.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. Today we're unearthing some seriously fantastical fungi that have been hotly debated since their discovery. Let's dig into Prototaxites.
Prototaxites were enormous fungi that dominated the landscape during the Devonian period. These telephone pole-like fungi ranged from 2 to 9 meters tall, and some were as big as 1 meter across.
Prototaxites were found on land all over the planet, but at the time, the continents and landscape looked a lot different.
For most of the Devonian period, today's North America, Greenland, and Europe were united into a single landmass called Laurasia, or Euramerica. Today's South America, Africa, India, Australia, and Antarctica formed another supercontinent called Gondwana.
The Devonian period spanned 60 million years, beginning 419 million years ago. It's best known as the Age of Fishes, since most life on Earth still existed in the water at this time.
85% of the planet was covered in oceans during the Devonian, compared to today's 70%. And the little land that did exist didn't have much going on. Slowly but surely, during this period, the formerly barren land started to become populated with small plants that would eventually evolve into the massive trees and vegetation we know today. The only land creatures were small invertebrates like arthropods, wingless insects, and early arachnids.
The barren landscape, low to the ground plant life, and lack of large creatures would have made Prototaxites stand out like a bunch of freaky sore thumbs.
These ginormous fungi would have been the tallest living things on the land, quite literally towering over everything else. It wasn't until the Middle Devonian period when other large plant species started to evolve, and these landscape-dominating giant fungi started to slowly fade into oblivion.
Until recently, we didn't even know for sure that Prototaxites were actually fungi. This species has been the source of debate since its discovery. And trust me when I say that debates can get heated in the paleobotany department. Shade has been thrown. The aggression has been positively passive.
It all began with geologist J.W. Dawson, who, in 1855, began to study a collection of fossils that had been dug up in Gaspé Bay, Canada, more than a decade earlier. Among them was one of the strangest fossils he'd ever seen. Because of the sheer size of the specimen, which would have stood 6 meters high and was half a meter across, Dawson named it Prototaxite.
This name, meaning early yew, was a nod to the fact that Dawson believed this strange fossil to be a coniferous tree.
He explained away the loosely organized tissue and meshwork of root-like fungal structures by claiming this particular tree was rotting when it became fossilized. And so began a ruthless, decades-long, science-y beef.
In 1872, paleobotanist William Carruthers ripped apart Dawson's theory, arguing that geologists who dominated the field of paleontology didn't know enough about plant morphology and characteristics to make any kind of judgment.
Burn.
Based on what he saw, Carruthers insisted that the giant specimen was clearly some kind of marine algae, despite evidence that it definitely grew on land. In a paleobiological FU for the ages, Carruthers renamed it nematophyton, meaning filamentous plant.
In response, Dawson clapped back, quote, "The tone and manner of the article, I may say in passing, are unnecessarily offensive, and the author bolsters up his argument by unfair assumptions that I am ignorant of some of the most familiar facts of structural botany, facts which were well known to me while he was yet a schoolboy," unquote. The lesson here, never tick off a scientist unless you're ready for some seriously scholarly burns.
Despite Dawson's counter-arguments, Carruthers' interpretation went largely unchallenged until 2001, when it was proposed that Prototaxites were actually fungi. In 2007, using isotopic analysis, this shroomy theory was confirmed.
Prototaxites were indeed most likely enormous mushrooms. We know this because plants only absorb carbon from the air around them, meaning that all plants analyzed during a specific time will have similar levels of carbon. Animals, on the other hand, get carbon from what they eat, so will have similar levels to whatever it is they're consuming. Fungi get their carbon from the nutrients they absorb through their root-like mycelia. The carbon in Prototaxites show they have different carbon levels than the plants around them, which proves they were not plants.
Like many fungi today, one theory is that prototaxites got their nutrients from breaking down and absorbing dead and decaying matter in the ground, likely from the small plants that blanketed the ground around them.
The size of prototaxites would suggest that their mycelium networks would have had to be enormous to support such huge structures.
Their giant size begs the question, what's the point in being so tall if you're not competing with anything else for resources? One theory points to how fungi reproduce, by throwing spores into the air and letting the wind take them. The logic here is that the taller the fruiting body which releases the spores, the further the wind can take them to populate far-flung areas.
Okay, so if they were so good at reproducing, where are all the prototaxites today? There are a few theories as to why we don't have enormous mushrooms towering over our current landscape.
We know that prototaxites became extinct towards the end of the Devonian period. It was at this time that vascular trees and shrubs started to evolve and overtake the land, probably outcompeting the prototaxites. Terrestrial insects and animals were also further evolving at this time. Specimens of prototaxites have been found with insect and arthropod boreholes, so other theories suggest that being snacked upon, combined with slow regeneration, could have also led to their ultimate demise.
While most scientists today agree that prototaxites were indeed fungi, the debate about what kind of fungi and how they survived for tens of millions of years still rages on. So, what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe for more videos every single week. Bye-bye.
We have exciting news. We're thrilled to announce the release of Animalogic's very first book, Strange Creatures. This book dives into the most incredible animals we've ever featured on the show, with each chapter packed with my illustrations and stunning full-color images. It's a fun and engaging way to learn about the animal kingdom, and a perfect tool to spark kids' interest in science. Each chapter breaks down an animal's biology, behavior, and all the coolest facts you need to know about these fascinating creatures. Animalogic's Strange Creatures is a must-have addition to your own library, or the perfect gift for an animal lover this upcoming holiday season. Click the link in the description to check it out, and if you can, order a copy. It would mean the world. Thank you so much, and I hope that you love the book.
And trust me when I say that debates can get heated in the paleobotany department. Shade has been thrown, and the passive no! Dawson believed this strange fossil to be a coniferous tree. The timing on these honks are great.
Really,
yeah. It's like we're like this nice exchange of sounds.